ain't much for waiting around.
Ah, my friends, that's resources standing around. There's glory to be won.
Sorry, I gotta get all the burps out. All right.
Don't worry, my friends. I am your shield. Sniper!
Alright, here we go. So we've got Banny on Tracer, looping around the side. He's already distracted the enemy team enough to pull them back onto the point and allow the rest of his team to get up into the capture. You can see them kind of camping in there for the time being, trying to take out this team, doing a concerted push together, trying to get onto the point there. There's two tanks, Winston and Reinhardt, both leading the charge, while Mercy is doing her best to keep them healed up. We are watching Id on Soldier 76 right now. He is a hitscan character, so he is going to be very accurate. He's also got a heal that he can drop on the ground that his teammates can benefit from, and it will actually heal him all the way to full if he stands in that radius the whole time. Trying to pick off Carnage there, leading forward with that 2,000 health shield. Reinhardt's shield has 2,000 health. That big blue Symmetra orb that you just saw float by actually ignores shields. It goes right through it. Today we're experimenting with mostly first-person view after reading a bunch of the feedback from Reddit and from YouTube. I'm going to be taking it a little slower as well to try and actually call things accurately. Right now the red team, consisting of Banny, Slasher, Flex, Tekkicide, Oplad, and Carnage, is going on the offense. It looks like Mercy did just use her ultimate to bring back Flex. Oplad jumping forward with Winston, popping his defensive bubble, so that Soldier can't really do as much damage. Soldier does pop in there with that Helix rocket, though. Let's switch over to CoolMat69. Did I just hear a yoo-hoo? Oh no, our follower sound's still going? I thought I disabled them. Okay, CoolMat taking out Farrah there pretty easily. Sorry guys in chat, I'm not going to be answering questions as much, trying to just do a practice cast here. If people in chat can be helpful to each other and answer each other's questions, or you know, feel free to have discussions as well. I'm just going to be looking at chat every once in a while to see if you guys have preferences, but I can't really answer questions and cast, so just keep that in mind. The bottom UI does not actually cover it. It's just incredibly useful for me as a spectator because it's the only thing I have that tells me who's dead, who's alive, and who has their ultimates. You see a little skull on the character when they're dead, and they also have a res timer when they're dead. It is weird that it's overlaid on top of the single FPOV, but it's all I got right now. And I like to have it up just because I can see ultimates, I can switch, you know, easily. I can see right now CoolMat does have Deadeye available. I like to, you know, see when players are setting up for some big damage. So McCree does get taken out there. We'll switch over to Roadhog over on the other side. Tailspin on defense, throwing out a hook and missing, but he does have his ultimate available as well. You can see that blue Symmetra teleporter through the wall there on the left side, so good job by the defense getting Symmetra that ultimate very quickly. Clock placing it. If you watched the matches last night, you know that Symmetra is very highly valued by all of the pro players so far. That teleport time that it reduces for players to return to the fight is incredibly valuable. Winston does get hooked there, but can't get pulled through the wall. Let's watch DeHang protecting the point here against these three incoming enemies. We've got Winston using his monkey ult to gain 1,000 health and go crazy. He can jump as much as he wants, and he can smack people away as much as he wants. Winston sometimes is used to actually knock people off the cliff here on Hanamura. Reaper's got his ult, Carnage, getting taken out there by a Lucio, actually. Minstrel also going down. Let's switch over to McCree, CoolMat, once again. as Banny is trying to duel him on the point. Banny gets taken out with that fan, as well as a Reinhardt fireball. Is this a high MMR match? Yes, it is. These guys are all former Team Fortress 2 or Quake pros, for the most part. I'm not sure exactly which game individually all of the players come from, but it looks like the blue team here is going to successfully defend. McCree getting a fair share of kills there. Red team made a concerted effort on the left side earlier, but was unable to actually push through that opening. So let's watch this play of the game.
Play of the game.
Very nice. Wasn't even a cheesy die, die, die. To make this a little simpler, maybe we'll call them the two teams by someone that's actually on each team. So maybe Team Dehang, Team Tailspin. Versus Team Carnage. They have the funniest names, best names. Slasher is also playing. For those of you who know Rod, he's enjoying Overwatch quite a lot. He whipped my ass on McCree in a PUG not too long ago. Not a PUG, actually, a casual match. This is considered a PUG. These guys are all just friends playing together on, you know, shuffled teams. All just trying to get better at the game. The blue team with Slasher and Carnage informed me that they had actually not played together yet, and so the red team has. This red team that we'll be attacking in now. So Carnage was actually, I believe, a TF2 player. Almost certain about that. Let's watch offense this time around. Let's see what Tailspin can do on Tracer. He had a 25 kill streak in the game before this that I was unable to stream. I was waiting on a delivery. But now that that's all dealt with, we can see what antics he gets up to with his awesome Tracer. Tailspin is a guy who you guys might not know too much about. He was actually a Shoot Mania pro back when I worked at IPL. He was one of the top two teams internationally at the Shoot Mania launch event. The other team was Fnatic. Was it Fnatic? Strengths' team? Yes, I believe it was Fnatic. Thank you for the follow. I appreciate it. I thought I disabled that sound. Let me check one more time and see if I can do something about that. We'll just watch Tracer's FPOV for now. What's up, Luxes? Nice to see you, man. Alright, back in the game. I disabled the sounds. I realized that I just forgot to click save, so now there will be no more follow alerts. But I do appreciate you guys following, and your names will appear at the top if you decide to follow. Alright, so Tracer running off all the way on his own. We're actually going to pull up this meter down on the bottom again. They successfully attacked A pretty quickly there. Let's switch to defensive McCree. He's going to have a tough job. Actually, of course, every time I switch to McCree, he is already dead, so let's go ahead and switch to Roadhog. Nope, he's already dead as well. Point B is going to be very difficult to defend at this point with the whole team dead. And wow, the red team totally slaughtering. Team Clock, Team Tailspin, just dominating. That was a little embarrassing. Very quick game. But that's all right. Everyone's learning. Everyone's trying to figure out how to play this game still.
Wonderful.
How's everyone doing on this fine Monday?